Hey guys, and welcome back to our channel. Today I have a very, very highly requested video topic to cover, and that is how to make dogs and ferrets coexist. The best tips and tricks that I have been using to help integrate again into our ferret family. Now, please do note that not all dogs will be able to get along with ferrets, and the same can be said for ferrets as well. Some ferrets are just petrified of dogs. They do not like other dogs. Thankfully, all of my ferrets are very tolerant of every person and animal thus far. So I felt very confident bringing Gen into our family. It is definitely not something that I would have done if they were any other way. My ferrets are here first, therefore they have the ultimate priority. And first, I just wanna say that I know that there are many people out there who firmly believe that dogs and ferrets should never be kept together, and that is a totally valid opinion. It is, however, not a fact or a rule. Sorry, they're now playing in the tube, but ferrets and dogs are definitely able to coexist peacefully as long as you follow the correct steps. But again, like I said, some dogs and some ferrets are just not capable of being together like that, which is totally fine and something that you should be prepared for. And the same can be said for cats, you know. A lot of people are against having dogs and ferrets together, yet they are totally fine with having cats and dogs unsupervised together all the time. And it's very... Appa! Of course, everyone's now playing with each other now. Appa and Remy are roughhousing, or sorry, Appa and Patsu. They look so similar now. Appa and Patsu are roughhousing, so you might hear them, you know, screeching in the background. But anyways, as I was saying, but yeah, ferrets and dogs can totally coexist with one another. And I'm here to just talk about sort of the process that I've been using, the process that I have used in the past to integrate Sedona with the ferrets as well, because she is allowed to be around them too, because she has learned and she's gone through the training to be with them safely. I know a big question is, can I let my dogs and ferrets out like unsupervised, like when I leave the house? And that's totally gonna be a personal thing. I know many people are gonna say, no, you need to supervise your animals, but I do personally know of many, many people who do actually allow their dogs and their ferrets to be out together unsupervised when they leave the house. Of course, this is not going to be appropriate for every situation. This is probably not something that I'll be doing just personally, just to keep everyone safe, and that's totally fine, whatever way you want to do it. I'm not going to tell you to do it one way or another way. All dogs and all ferrets are totally different. Of course, I don't want people to take what I say out of context and say that I'm telling people to leave their ferrets and dogs unsupervised. That is not what I'm saying. I just know a lot of people personally who do that and who have had success with that, and there are many people who just choose to not take that risk and have every interaction supervised, and that's totally fine. So before diving into the tips and tricks that I've been using to integrate my dog and my ferrets together, I wanted to talk a little bit about breed specific behaviors, because most breeds were bred for a purpose. For example, you know, border collies and cattle dogs were born to herd livestock and cattle. Great Pyrenees and those types of breeds are bred to protect livestock. Oh my gosh, Appa is screeching in the background playing with Remy. Ah. You know, German Shorthair pointers are bred to point and bird hunt. Labrador retrievers are meant to retrieve fallen birds, etc. So a lot of these breeds have instinctual behaviors that are just in their DNA. So if you have like a cattle dog, for example, you might experience them trying to herd the ferrets or your cats or children. It's just something that they do. And so knowing that and knowing more about the origin of your breed is gonna be very helpful to formulate method of integration for your pets. That being said though, just because your dog was bred to hunt rats, like rat terriers, doesn't mean that they're going to be unable to be around your ferrets. It is all about the training and setting them up for success. It is still just a good thing to know. So you're gonna wanna use mostly positive reinforcement techniques. However, you may need to use negative reinforcement in the forms of timeouts, just to keep the animals safe. There might be times where your dog is just getting too excited and too much, in which case you may need to give them sort of like a time out. One of the biggest tips that I can give you, and if it's something that's in your control, the younger the dog, the easier it's gonna be to integrate them in. If you're starting with an older dog, I'm not saying that it can't be done. It might be a little bit more difficult because they already have sort of ingrained habits and behaviors. The key is also gonna be short and quick sessions, multiple during the day. I know he can't help it because he's deaf, but it is very, very frustrating. Anyways, you're gonna wanna always set them up for success. You're not gonna wanna have them play or interact when your dog is very overtired really overstimulated, you're gonna wanna set them up for success. So what I do is I will let Gen interact with them when he's kind of more tired, but not overtired, where he's willing to listen and be gentle, pretty much. And that's gonna be different for every dog. And the same goes for your ferrets as well. You don't wanna have them playing when your ferrets are just having a bad day, or they just really wanna sleep all day. They don't feel like playing or interacting. And in the beginning, definitely supervise all interactions. I wouldn't, you know, trust your dog or your ferrets completely yet, because yes, ferrets are capable of hurting your dog, especially a young puppy as well. So that's something you're gonna wanna watch out for. And actually, ferrets themselves do a lot of the work, most of them. Of course, some ferrets are just gonna be really, really docile to your dog, but a lot of them will actually correct your puppy as well for you. So that's very helpful, just so that your dog kind of learns from the ferret themselves that this is what I'm okay with, this is what I'm not okay with, and so on. Taking the tube away, they are going crazy right now. And some other helpful methods that I have personally utilized would be walking your dog and your ferrets together. That way they are just more distracted on the environment. And while doing so, they kind of get used to being around each other and being in each other's company. Another one would just be having them play together. So playing with your ferret's favorite toys, your dog's favorite toys, just together. But anyways, I think that's where I'm gonna actually stop the video. I feel like I didn't really get to talk about much, but my ferrets are just going insane, and that's just the reality of having ferrets. This is the only time that I get to film, so unfortunately I'm gonna have to cut it. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to cut it short, but hopefully I got some good, you know, information in there. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!